Dens. My name is Lauren White, and I'm doing my 10-minute introduction and body of my first lesson plan for my thematic unit. It's about reading and the Winter Olympics. And the article that we're doing is Winter Olympics, More Than Just Sports. Today I have my friend recording, helping me record this. Thank you very much. And I also have another friend. Her name's Angela. She'll be participating as one of my mock students in this lesson plan. So first, I just want to go over, what is a sport? What exactly is a sport? When we think of a sport, what do we think of? Angela, what do you think a sport is?
Oh, so there are sports that you can do alone, and there's sports on TV, like football or baseball, something like that.
Definitely. So great response, Angela. So sports are, you can do sports alone. Sports alone could be like swimming, running, ice skating, or there could be team sports such as soccer, basketball, and football. Those are examples of team sports. And so what is your favorite sport, Angela?
For me to do?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Bicycling. I like to bike.
Why do you like to bike?
Because I can go around my neighborhood. I don't need to go very far to have fun.
Perfect. So that's one good example. So bicycling is a good example of a sport that you can do on your own. You can do it in your neighborhood. Another good sport you can do in your neighborhood is you can do basketball. There's a basketball hoop just around the corner, and people get together and play basketball. So that's a team sport you can do in your neighborhood. It's a good example, Angela. Thank you. Okay, so today's objective is to read and understand a current events news article. And I'll let you know, so the news article is about the Olympics, the Winter Olympics. Who has heard of the Winter Olympics? Angela, what have you heard about the Winter Olympics?
Oh, I've been watching it on TV. It's mm-hmm. really beautiful. All these different countries come with their athletes. There's a lot of different types of sports and medals. Yeah, they're medals.
I really like that word athlete. Can you explain what athlete means for the rest of the class?
These are people who are are really working hard to be the best at what they do. So they train and they compete with other people.
Great, definitely. Very good definition of athlete. Thank you, Angela. Okay, so I wanted to talk about a little bit of the history of the Olympics. So Olympics started about 2,700 years ago in Greece. So Greece is a country in Europe, and it started in Olympia, Greece, hence the name Olympics. So when it started in Olympia, Greece, it was originally to honor Zeus, and Zeus in the Greek mythology, which means like the Greek religion, was the king of the gods. So this whole idea of the games was to honor him, and they would have it occur every 4 years, just like we have now. Every 4 years we have the winter, and every 4 years we have the summer. Those are the two Olympics we have now. So that's a little bit about the history of the Olympics. I also wanted to preview some vocabulary. We're going to encounter some difficult words in this reading, but let's unpack them before we do the reading. So the three vocabulary words I want to focus on are significant, politically, and reprimand. So without doing the reading, without having our context clues, which can help us, what do you think significant means, Angela?
Significant?
What do you like, have you heard of the word before? Okay, that's okay. So significant means very important. Something that's significant, like a birthday is a significant event in someone's life. It's a very important event in someone's life. Now, politically is talking about the government. It's talking about the affairs or the activities of the government. That's what politically means. And reprimand, what do you think reprimand means, Angela?
I don't know.
Okay, so reprimand, we'll see that one in the text. We'll unpack that a little bit later when we get back into the text. So So now what I want to do is just take a minute or two to read the article. It's called Winter Olympics, More Than Just Sports. So I'm going to read the article and just pay attention to the main ideas, which we'll discuss later. Okay. The article is Winter Olympics, More Than Just Sports by Joyce Grant. And it says, the 2018 Winter Olympic Games are on now in Pyeongchang, South Korea. The location is very significant. South Korea and North Korea are not on friendly terms, but the Olympics may be bringing them closer together politically. North Korea is a dictatorship. That means one person rules it. That person is Kim Jong-un, known as the Supreme Leader. He is known for being extremely strict and harsh with his country's people. He keeps his country separated from the rest of the world. It is usually hard to know what is going on in North Korea because free communication is not allowed in or out of the country. But the Winter Olympics may help to thaw relations between North and South Korea. With the world's greatest athletes, just like that word you brought earlier, Angela, thank you, competing in Pyeongchang, the leaders of the two republics are beginning to communicate more. They have also combined their athletes who compete for, simply, Korea. Kim Jong-un sent his sister, Kim Yo-jung, to the Olympics to represent the North Korea. Unlike her brother, Kim Jong-un, who is seen by most people as a harsh dictator, Kim Yo-jung is striking a chord with people, according to CNN News. In this case, striking a chord means that people are warming up to her. Something else has happened. North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un has asked for a meeting in Pyeongchang with the president of South Korea, Moon Jae-in. There hasn't been a meeting between the two republics in more than 10 years. This is seen as a good sign because although they still may not get along, at least they will be communicating. Meanwhile, there is a lot of exciting sports action happening at the Olympic Games. There are 15 winter sports, including ice hockey, curling, luge, speed skating, figure skating, and snowboard. There are also many personal stories of triumph and victory at the Olympics. Each country has a designated broadcaster who officially covers the Olympic Games for that country. They typically feature personal stories of their country's athletes. One other major thing that is happening in the Olympics this year is that Russia was found guilty of trying to cheat in past Olympics. The country was reprimanded by the International Olympic Committee and told that most of its athletes would not be allowed to compete under the Russian flag. Many of them are competing, but as athletes from Russia, rather than representing Russia. This seems to be a small distinction, but it is significant. For instance, if any of those athletes win a medal, the Russian anthem will not be played for them. And there's one side note that North Korea is officially called the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and South Korea is officially called the Republic of Korea. So now, based on our reading, Angela, can you give us a couple main ideas from the text?
Having trouble.
Having trouble. That's okay. So to summarize the text talks about the two leaders of North Korea and South Korea. Can you remember, is North Korea the dictator or the president?
Dictator.
Dictator, correct. And South Korea is the president. And this Winter Olympics may be bringing them together to talk, and they haven't talked in a long time. Then also, there's a bit about Russia and how Russia was reprimanded, so they were corrected for something they did wrong, and they can't have anyone representing Russia in the Olympics. Okay? So those are the two main points. There's also a side note about the different Olympic sports that are happening in South Korea right now. Angela, could you name one or two of the Olympic sports happening from the article?
Ice skating.
Ice skating, good. What's another one?
Hockey, which is kind of like ice skating.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so hockey is like a team sport where people on ice skates compete in like a team setting. It's very fun to watch. And yes, ice skating is also part of it. Okay. So, definitely two good things. There's a few more words that I wanted to go over. So, a couple words I found we're guilty. What does guilty mean? Angela, do you have any ideas?
Guilty. No, I don't understand.
Okay, that's okay. You know, we'll come back to it because we're going to finish up our little lesson right now. For homework, I want you to watch some Olympics on TV and write a little bit about what you watched. Bring it back to class tomorrow, and we'll continue our discussion of the Winter Olympics. Thank you very much, and goodbye.